We welcome you to the Solstice Singers Spring 2004 program, The Gifts of Love. We invite you to sit back, turn off your cell phones, wrap your watches around so that you're not tempted to look at them, so that we can time travel, so that we can go back to the courtly entertainments, country, court, and chapel, the entertainments of the medieval and Renaissance time, and enjoy the frolics, the festivities, welcoming summer. So, with no further ado, I welcome you to the Gifts of Love, the Solstice Singers Mother's Day gift to the mothers of the cake.
Thank you. just the first.
When youth and blood are warmer. But being spent, the worst.
And worse times still succeed the former.
Then be not coy, but use your time. And while ye may, go marry. For having lost but once your prime, ye may forever tarry.
Thank you. the largest of all in this place. Mark how it becometh the midst of my face. By measure I take it from end to the brow, 4 inches by the compass, I'm sure you'll allow. Neither Wendell nor Dan, who make us all merry, with a bright cherry noses, more red than cranberry. None here to my challenge can make a denial, with my nose thrust forward here, bravely to the trial. Room for good noses, the best in our town. Come, fill the bottles, your ale is brown. For his nose and mine shall not quarrel, so long as 1 gallon remains in the barrel.
My nose is the longest, no man can deny, for 'tis a just handful, right down from my eye. Most seemly down, hanging down low to my chin, as if into my belly it fain would look in. It serves as a weapon, my mouth to defend. My teeth it preserveth still, like a good friend, if I should happen to fall on the ground. My nose takes the burden and keeps my face sound.
My nose is the broadest, how like you, sir, that? It feeds on good liquor and grows very fat. Like to a panache, it covers my face to make other noses the more in disgrace. For having the broadest and the fairest to the eye, the sergeant of noses appointed am I. Then let my nose challenge the chiefest of the rest. Of all other noses, the broadest is best.
Room for good noses, the best in our town. Come fill the pot, hostess, your ale is brown. For his nose and mine shall not quarrel, so long as 1 gallon remains in the barrel.
My nose is the flattest of all that be here, devoid of all danger and bodily fear. When other long noses let fly at a post, my nose has some advantages on the people's. Oh, no, but a brutal and some small grace might bring us less trouble on 200 face. Then let my nose challenge of all that be here to sit at this table as chiefest and cheer.
My nose is the sharpest, good neighbor, not well. The smoke of a banquet 3 mile I can smell. Boarded and shaped, so sharp at the end, makes known that I pass not what others do spend. Likewise it delighteth to peep in the cup, searching it deeply till all be drunk up. Then let my notes challenge all noses of best. The sharpest with the ladies is much in request.
The world for good noses, the best in our town. Come fill the pot, hostess, your ale it is brown. For his nose and thy nose and mine shall not quarrel, so long as 1 gallon remains in the barrel.
Thank you.
comes before us, he seems for to fly, and he pants to the chorus of the lamp in full cry.
The fox runs before us, he seems for to fly, and he pants to the chorus of the hunt in full cry. And the merry, merry, merry horn cries, come, come away. And the merry, merry, merry horn cries, come, come away. Awake from your slumber,
away. And the merry, merry, merry.
Thank you.
compare thee to a summer's day. Thou art more lovely and more temperate.
Rough winds do shake
the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a day.
Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed.
And sometimes fair from fair declines by nature's changing course, untrimmed.
But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines of time thou growest. So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
Thank you. The laborer lay listening to the nightingale throughout the summer's night. So pleased was he with it that the next night he set a trap for it and captured it.
"Now that I have caught thee,"
he cried,
"thou shalt always sing to me."
"We nightingales never sing in a cage,"
cried the bird.
"Then I'll eat thee,"
he said.
"I have always heard tell that nightingale on toast is a dainty morsel."
"No, eat me not, and I'll tell thee three things far better worth than my poor body."
So the laborer let the nightingale go, and she flew up high into a tree.
"Never believe a captive's promise. That's one thing. Then again, keep what you have. And my third piece of advice to you, sorrow not over that which is lost to you forever."
And the nightingale flew away.
Thank you.
La, la, la.
Bye.